I'm here to demonstrate to you the Vote for Safety package. It all comes in a nice box like this. All you have to do is unpack it and start using it. Straightforward. The first thing is you need to know what you're voting for. And that's what really is the core process of this. It's coming up with a ballot paper. Here's an example from Northern, which is about their key safety areas. Here's one example from SA Mint, where they selected 7 items to become their non-negotiable safety issues. So you customize this depending on the needs, the issues, the challenges, and what you would like to get out. The ideal result from this process is to get something that you can pull into your safety strategy to go forward by engaging everybody and saying you voted for this. So the key is to draw up the ballot paper. And once you've done that, my recommendation is always to involve the safety reps to run the process, because there's no rocket science behind it. Once you've decided, you can then start making up the voting materials. So you make up posters. Here is a poster for SAMUT. Here is a nice poster which was done for ESCOM, which has a name and a telephone number on it. And the other thing you can see, it comes with holes on a piece of cardboard, piece of string, so you can string it up against lamp posts. And people come to work one morning, they will see all these posters right along the way that they come to work. It's all something that can be customized with this program once you know what you're voting for. Here, for instance, you have flags. You can make up flags and dish out the flags to the people to campaign before the time for, what is this one? Do not sign off safety documents that you don't understand. You can go along and make up some bumper stickers for the whole process and say, I'm voting for safety. You can go down the road of making little buttons. I vote for safety. Or you can use the idea of a personalized key ring with a photo and a name on it. You go with a nice big banner. This now hasn't been made up for the voting as such. It's really put up at the gate, which says voting day, 1st of January. It is a wise move to make the safety reps into the group of people who are going to run the whole process. So each one of them will get a vest. This one here says safety election official. The chief safety election officer who is going to oversee the whole process. Now, once you've got all that in place, you've done the campaigning, and you are now ready for the voting, you've got the ballot papers printed, the banners are up, the posters are up, the flags are done, people are all excited. We're going to now do the voting. We put up the polling station. Inside the polling station, we're putting up the polling box. So it's a box, nice, flat folded. It will then say polling booth for the second day. And here is the box, fold up box. There it is, lid on. And here's your polling box. So for that, we have also a flat pack. We put it together and we put on the side some branding to just tape it up so that it becomes more rigid. And this is a little table. And then the process is exactly the same. Person comes to the first desk where an election official will tick him off on the employee register. Then he comes to the second station. Personalized keyring would be the best, because then you can say, what's your name? Oh, it's Nti Mchengo. There's your keyring. Now you're ready to go and vote. I've got my key, I can vote for safety. And then you could go to the next station and the guy gives you a ballot paper, taking a ballot of a box, standing down, hold your paper, smile for the camera, and put it in. And then afterwards, the process is a process of counting. You need to do it fast, and you need to do it fair and transparent. So it doesn't take you 2 weeks to count ballots. We have it by the end of the day and say, here's the result. Make it a nice public announcement to make sure that it has credibility. And then this whole process will give you an end result which is totally unbelievable in the sense that people actually buy into whatever the outcome of the election is. They will say, we have voted for this. So when you implement that result, it's a piece of cake. We have individually cast our vote to make a difference. You will have to, right throughout the process, make 110% sure that you have leadership buy-in.